all my topics have to be related to my background, where I am from.
I'm coming from an Inca culture. I was born in Peru. I live in front of a port, so, you know, it's very active. We are close to the mountains, to the Andes, and also close to the Amazon as well. And so we are connected by culture and environment. I think my town is a lot of proudness about our culture. I think I normally realized that I was more interested in art when I came out here at Morehead. This is not a very multicultural place. I couldn't find a job. And so I began searching for my inner self. That is when I, you know, all my love wake up for art. Paintings, because of the colors that they are, you know, they are alive, they are bright. I think they speak, you know, about my technique a lot. I install them here sometimes in my house. For me, it's so important because my paintings take me more than a year. I really love it to have it with me because I come back. I can still, you know, be pushing away. I can see many people also, you know, just being attached to one media and they keep that, but that is not how my brain works. I would like, you know, somebody to study my brain probably and to see why I switch so much. So what happens with me is mostly is the theme. I choose a theme and the theme brings me to the media. They can be sculpture, they can be ceramic, or they can be paintings, or they can be like a mixed media. Many times I have to even learn how to do it. So I have to teach myself. Material mostly is just a way for me to inform about a specific topic. I make a lot of things for fun, but then also I'm very political. I have one topic about Joe Arpaio, the sheriff, that used to make all Latinos wear pink underwears. So I make his face using underwears. So that was new because I have to sew, I have to embroider. I never did that before. So I get moved by the topic. I began wondering who are the people that married, you know, these dictators? Who were the women that are okay having husbands that, you know, commit genocide crimes? So I began embroidering their faces. But I was thinking that they will not work by itself if the men are not behind them. I'm also in the scale. It's a compromise. It's an acceptance. This situation of terror. So this is my husband's face. He always was complaining that people never say hello to him. Like, he blends so much here, and he was like, you know, all the time dropping the topic to me that people don't recognize, but I had a meeting with this person, like, I have a common face, you know, common features. You know, many people don't have sculptures of themselves, and because we are regular, we are common. This piece, I think, has the topic of see me, recognize me. And he was happy that, you know, somebody makes something of him. I think I don't try to harass my viewers to feel guilty or to feel sad. If they feel something, they will search for more information, or they will just look at it as it is, you know, a pleasant object or, you know, art piece and walk away. I don't feel offended. It's just something that I really love. If I can afford just something, you know, to touch these topics or to help, even to open a communication, I'm happy about that.
Funded by the Minnesota Arts and Cultural Heritage Fund, with money from the vote of the people of Minnesota on November 4th, 2008. And by the members of Prairie Public.